Previously in this YouTube series, the rationalizer said that the Quran permits sex with girls too young to have started their periods. LearnQuranicArabic said this verse refers to older women whose periods have temporarily stopped due to a word he could not pronounce. The rationalizer used numerous tafsirs and scholars to show that this verse does indeed refer to girls too young to have started their periods. LearnQuranicArabic has now apparently accepted this refers to girls too young to have had periods, but now says that the case put forward by the rationalizer has still not been made sufficiently, as it has not shown that this is a consummated marriage.
Right then. Let's get started.
Nikah is a marriage agreement between two people. At some point, this nikah may or may not be consummated. So, let's look at the three relevant verses in the Quran. Chapter 2, verse 2 to 8, chapter 33, verse 49, and chapter 65, verse number 4. First, it is important to determine the order in which these verses were spoken by Muhammad. In this case, the sequential order matches the chronological order. Let's take a look at what these verses say and what the tafsirs say about them. Al-Jalalayn says, the iddah here is three menstrual cycles in order to determine a penetrated woman is not pregnant. Tafsîr Ibn Abbâs also says that iddah here is three menstrual cycles to determine the wife is not pregnant. Ibn Kathir says this three menstrual cycles is to determine whether or not the woman is pregnant. These tafsirs agree that this waiting period, or iddah, is to determine whether or not the wife is pregnant, and the wife is not permitted to conceal either her menstrual blood or her pregnancy from her husband. The next verse chronologically was chapter 33, verse 49. Al-Jalalayn concludes that no iddah is required when there is no need to preclude pregnancy. Ibn Abbas says there is no iddah if you have not had sex with them, neither by counting menstrual cycles or any number of months. Ibn Kathir describes this verse in great detail. First, he points out that this is the most clear verse in the Quran differentiating between the contract of marriage and the consummation. He then goes on to explain the no iddah rule only applies to wives with whom you have not yet had sex. And now on to the verse in question. Chapter 65, verse number 4. According to the following tafsirs and scholars, the words, those who have it not, is referring to girls too young to have had their first period.
Thank you.
this is what I would call a clear-cut case. When divorcing a woman with whom you have not had sex, there is no waiting period, or idda, in order to preclude pregnancy. Yet the verse in question says that when divorcing a wife too young to have started her periods, the idda one must wait is 3 calendar months, the same amount of time one must wait to determine a menstruating wife is not pregnant.
Now that all the evidence is on the table, clearly showing the Quran permits grown men to have sex with little girls, what will Learn Quranic Arabic do next? Will he ignore the conclusions of all these scholars and simply insist the rationalizer has used an incorrect translation? Will he defer thinking about it until after he is dead by saying, Allah knows best? Or will he try to convince the world that sex with premenarchal girls is acceptable? These questions and many others will be answered in Learn Quranic Arabic's next installment of this YouTube soap.
I think therefore the hypothesis stands. Either the Quran gives grown men permission to have sex with girls so young that they have not yet started their periods, or the Quran is monstrously unclear on the issue and is thus imperfect.